Every night, the same dream. The same strange planet. But why? What are they trying to tell me? It's been 34 years since they arrived on this planet. And not a day passes that the survivors, forced to live in barrier cities, do not live in fear. I have vowed to end that fear. I believe my dreams hold the key. The question is, will I be in time to save the Earth?
Hello, I'm Devin DiNardo, and I'm joined here with Luis Alvarez and Clint Keaton, and we are reviewing Final Fantasy Spirits Within. This movie is directed by Hironobu Sakaguchi, distributed by Columbia Pictures, with an MPAA rating of PG-13 for sci-fi violence. Sci-fi action violence. The story is about a Dr. Aki Ross in efforts to save Earth from some mysterious aliens known as Phantoms.
Phantoms. That's it.
That is all.
Welcome back, Captain.
We're clean.
Let's make sure of that, shall we?
I hate getting scanned.
Sir, these scanners are probably worse for us than the Phantoms.
No, probably about it, Captain. These machines are suspected of causing sterility, and I want to have a little Neil Jr. calling me Daddy someday.
That's a spooky thought.
Why are you always busting my chops?
People, let's just do this thing, all right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All right, Devin.
What
let's
up?
Start off about the presentation. What's your opinion?
Well, personally, I love the presentation of this movie. I gave it a 10. It looks phenomenal. It looks gorgeous. The movement of all the characters looks great. The hair is kind of cool. Just everything just looks absolutely gorgeous. The sound is awesome. Everything sounds, pretty cool. The machine guns sound like machine guns. The voice acting was great.
I agree.
You got a Ming-Na who played Chun-Li in the Street Fighter movie. Steve Buscemi. You got Ving Rhames. You've got who is Alec Baldwin, James Woods, Donald Sutherland as well.
Yep.
He played Sid. The casting was great, but just the way that the actors were able to portray their characters without actually being physical actors, it made for a great story. An entertaining story, by the way.
Yeah. You know, I thought it was a great job, especially visually and just the sound and the music. Especially for the time, this is 2 or 3 years ago now?
Oh, no. Boy, no, this is around 2000, 2001, dude.
There you go. I mean, it was spectacular then. And
released July 11th, 2001.
We watched it, recently on Blu-ray, and it's still spectacular. I mean,
yeah, it is.
Anything out today, I don't think I've seen anything out today that can compare this to this, the graphics and the sound that, that they put out on this film. And then, like Devo said, I gave it a 10 as well. And, like I said, Hideki said, acting was awesome. You put Steve Buscemi in a film, making it sound like Steve Buscemi. It's fucking great. And they did all a great job.
And one thing I liked as well is the way the Phantoms looked. Not
yeah,
just like the way they were creatures, because the creatures looked like skinnier versions of those alien guys from The Fifth Element. But when they were in their ghost versions and the humans or the military or whatever had this special, I don't know what it was. It was kind of like a flare gun where they shoot up in the air and all these little dust things would fall from the sky. But when it hit one of the Phantoms, you'd be able to see them and they looked like an orange, glowy, X-ray type looking thing. And it just looked pretty badass.
It was cool.
I like it.
Yeah.
I also have to give Lucho mentioned he didn't see anything else that looked better than this. I think there is one thing out there that looks better than this. That's Final Fantasy VII Advent Children.
Right.
But it was
right.
Obviously released afterwards. But I still give the presentation a 10. They're superb. They're spectacular. Like Lucho said, on Blu-ray specifically, it looks great. I mean, realistically, the face movement, it's the best I've ever seen on a CG movie ever. Yeah. And, some of the clothes could be a little bit better. But I mean, everything in there is everything other than that is probably absolutely, it's perfect. Looking pretty
not,
much.
Not just the face movement, but just the animation in general of the characters, the humans, even the vehicles and the ships and the way the aliens move, they were just so organic.
And even the way they walked, the way their hands moved, the way that they walked around, the way their clothes moved, and like I said, specifically their facial movement when they were talking, you don't normally see that type of thing in a CG movie looking so good. It really looked good. You actually were watching it and you weren't thinking about, wow, that person's, you know, whatever, talking, you know what I mean? Yeah. It does look shitty, you know what I mean? But, you know, also I thought the sound was outstanding. The music is good, you know? Yeah. It really was good. I mean, well, everything around it.
Nobuo Uematsu, right?
I don't think so. I don't know if you want to look there, but I don't think he composed it. But because it's like an orchestrated score. But, dude, it looks... It's spectacular. Like Lucho said, there's nothing else other to say. You know? It just looks great. 10.
10. The orchestra for the movie was conducted by Belgian composer Dirk Brasse. The film's director, Hironobu Sakaguchi, opted for the acclaimed film composer instead of Nobuo Uematsu.
There you go. Still 10.
It doesn't matter. It's still a 10.
Screw you, Hironobu.
10.
Members of the council. Gathering plants and animals from around the world to fight the phantoms is utter nonsense. The Zeus cannon is a proven, effective weapon. It will kill phantoms. Can we afford to wait for some crazy invention, some army of touchy-feely plants and animals? An invention that offers no solid evidence that it will destroy the aliens.
There is evidence. Our partially completed energy wave has successfully stopped phantom particles from spreading through a terminally infected patient.
Doctor, do you claim to have evidence that a terminal patient has been cured?
Not cured. The wave is not complete. But we've succeeded in containing the particles safely inside the patient.
Where is the proof?
Here.
So, Devin, in the world of Final Fantasy, the spirits within an Earth 2065, you were quite entertained, were you not?
I like this movie. I was thoroughly entertained. I enjoyed the story. I enjoyed the characters. I enjoyed all the things that happened within it. I enjoyed the technology. I enjoyed this movie.
What was your score?
I give it a 9.
9?
A big fat 9.
Wow, that's impressive.
I know you guys don't particularly care for the film. That's your shortcomings. No pun intended.
Fucking man.
But this is kind of
movie. It's like a personal.
This is the kind of movie I can watch over and over and over. I mean, I'm not gonna watch it every day, all day, but I can watch it and like I get in the mood to be like, you know what? I want to watch Final Fantasy Spirits Within, and so I pop it in my DVD player and I watch it. I personally liked it. I like sci-fi. I hate fantasy games. I don't play World of Warcraft anymore because I don't like that fantasy stuff. I don't really get into these Final Fantasy stories because I don't like running around as magicians and sword-wielding douchebags with gay hair and androgynous-looking pieces of crap. But I like...
That's true. They are androgynous.
That's why I don't play Final Fantasy anymore.
I like laser guns. I like spaceships. I like... giant aliens, and I like blowing shit up. That's what this movie was. This was my connection to Final Fantasy. That's why I thoroughly enjoyed it.
Now, on the other end of the spectrum, Gooch.
Dude, you know, I gave it a 1. And the reason why, it's not that it's a bad film, mind you. When I went into the film back in 2000, I was a highly, highly, I love Final Fantasy. 2001, whatever. I'm a Final Fantasy fan.
Yes.
Not now because they're all androgynous fucks that you don't have to watch them. But like even in part 7, you know, at least part 7 had like it had the black dude. What's his name?
Cloud.
No, the black dude. The black.
Oh, Barrett.
At least he's manly. Well, I mean he's a dude. But I mean if you're gonna play it, you're gonna look like a woman.
His arm was a machine gun.
Play
shit,
chick,
motherfucker.
You know?
Don't mean shit.
But
like,
either way,
man.
I mean I went into this film expecting like a Final Fantasy film. And
he had a brother in this movie too.
True. Hey, Green Reigns was tight.
No, I'm not saying that it's... Like I said, I went in this film expecting a Final Fantasy film. I didn't get it. And that's the problem. And maybe if they would have named it something else, like...
Just taking off the Final Fantasy
Final
part.
Fantasy, I might have actually enjoyed it a little bit more.
Really?
But
so simply because of the fact that it had the words Final Fantasy in front of the title?
I went in 2001, okay? Went in. I was bored through the first half of the film because it's beautiful. But for you know, you get bored of it after half an hour.
So you still would have enjoyed it no matter if it wasn't a Final Fantasy movie.
Yeah, I said I might have enjoyed it a little bit more.
So you might have got a 2.
I might have got a 2. I didn't like
wow.
it.
Wow.
All
right, I'm in the middle of you guys. And you know, watching this movie again, I really tried to look at it objectively. Like Lucho said, if it wasn't a Final Fantasy movie, did I like it? And I still didn't like the movie. It's just not that great of a movie. I really thought it like... The last like half 45 minutes to half hour, it got boring and it really dragged on. I was like, when is this thing gonna end? You know, yeah. I mean the characters. I don't think they're that captivating. I don't think they're that deep. I don't think they go into their backstories, how they got there, or even how Earth got there. Too much. I mean, they do explain it, but this is not that good. I really didn't think. I mean, of course, like I mentioned, Ving Rhames is a badass. He's a badass, you know, but it's not enough, dude. And I'm not saying that it was terribly acted. I think it was well acted. And I think the reason why I gave it a 4 is because the graphics were spectacular. Like, the half of the movie, you're sitting there like, wow. You know, how did they make it look that good? But, you know, the detail is unrivaled. I mean, it truly is a visual marvel, and it showed the pinnacle of what computer graphics could be. But come on, dude. As a movie? Dude, if you just make this a live-action movie, it was terrible. It's maybe not that good, dude.
Maybe they would have made a film when those aliens first actually got there.
Yeah.
It might have been actually
more exciting. Aliens? This ain't Final Fantasy, dude.
No, it's not.
Come on. Aliens?
It could have been Earth, the spirits within. Seriously, and that would have made a lot of sense.
Hey, you know what? It would have, and you know, maybe like you said, it would have made us have a different view of it.
Yeah, I agree.
But just for a film, I gave it 4. And I think overall, what did we end up giving that one?
For the entertainment?
Yeah.
Averaged out to a 5.
Yeah, averaged out to a 5.
So fine. You know what? I'll just go watch a movie by myself.
Yeah.
Fuck you guys.
That's fine.
Sir, I have numerous phantom contacts.
Well, of course you do.
Outside of Sector 31, sir, and moving at incredible speed.
Major, what the hell is going on here?
They're in the pipes. They're moving with the bioetheric energy flow.
That's impossible. No living thing could survive in those pipes.
Well, we've got a big one heading this way. Metaclass, sir.
Oh my God. Hold your fire!
So, Devo, how relevant do you think that the Final Fantasy Spirits Within was to the Final Fantasy series?
Well, after further delegation, I had to lower my score down to a 1.
Well, you know, what was your score?
My original score was a 3.
Well, then tell us why it's a 3.
So, I thought it was a 3 because, well, you know, I mean, all right, so you get the Cid character, and like Clint, you know, when we were talking off air, the whole Gaia life thing, whatnot, but what Final Fantasy story is like the other one?
This is true. This is something that...
No Final Fantasy story is connected.
No, I agree.
Tony made this argument to me.
They're not connected. And there are specific aspects to each story that kind of connect them, like Cid and Gaia. But, you know, that's what it was. It was its own standalone Final Fantasy story. It didn't take place back in some weird... sword and sorcerer type of story. It was a futuristic machine gun military type game.
But unfortunately, the Final Fantasy really was supposed to be a Final Fantasy type game, like a fantasy type game. True, the new ones are they're
more like sci-fi.
They're evolving.
But they're still on some weird planet. It's on Earth.
Steampunk type thing, but they still use swords.
They still use magic.
Where are all the Aspers, and all where all the magic? I don't know what they call them now. But the least they
could have done is like healing with ethers and Phoenix Dawns. Exactly. They could have at least said that.
I'm surprised they didn't say anything like that. The reason why I give this Reynolds 1, they had Cid. That's my only.
Yeah.
One. They have Cid. And I mean, you could have called this anything else but Final Fantasy. It would have been exactly the same.
Lucio, I have to wholeheartedly agree with you because, I mean, I give it a 1. And the only reason it even gets that 1 is because if they didn't have Cid in there, it'd be 0. Because it had nothing to do with Final Fantasy. It occurs on Earth, which is ridiculous.
Yeah.
I mean, there's no, like, other than the Phantoms, there's no, like, creatures. There's supposed to be, like, a variance of creatures in all the games. No matter what Final Fantasy game, there's just tons of different types of creatures. And they utilize, like, a lot of, like, even... The games that are like, you know, based off science fiction, they still use a lot of like mythology in there.
Yeah.
Old mythology like Odin and stuff like that. And there's nothing like that in this.
You know, I'm even surprised they didn't put like other reoccurring mobs like the Moogles and like there's
Or the Chocobos. Chocobos is in every single Final Fantasy.
I'm surprised they didn't put the Chocobos in there.
You know why? You know why? Because Chocobos are gay.
But no, that's cool. It's a Final Fantasy.
It's a Final Fantasy staple.
Giant chicken.
Dude, hey, it's still Final Fantasy.
It's a Final Fantasy staple. Or like the little turtle guys with the knives. I don't remember what their names are. But
I forget.
Michelangelo,
Raphael. The Gaia Life Force thing that Devin mentioned, that actually is... It's not in all the Final Fantasies, but it is
recently,
in some of them.
Yeah, in some of them.
You know what I mean? So, I mean, realistically, like Lucho said, I mean, if you change the name of this and just make it a CG movie called... Spirits Within.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be Final Fantasy.
Yeah.
The only reason I think it really is because Square made it.
Yep.
Realistically, it has nothing to do with Final Fantasy. So if you're looking for a Final Fantasy movie,
go watch it.
Yeah. So our overall total, all three of our scores combined, equal a big fat 1.
Uno.
There. Wait. You'll understand.
Wait, Doctor.
That's a one-way trip.
Yes, yes, I expected that's how you would evaluate our chances.
Well, am I wrong?
No, I agree. We probably won't live long enough to extract the eighth spirit from the crater.
Then why should we even try it?
Because we don't need to extract the eighth spirit.
If we can't bring the final spirit here, we can go there and complete the wave inside the crater.
Yes, exactly.
And how do we do that, exactly?
I can construct a device that would attach to Aki's chest plate to gather the eight spirits, and then...
And then what?
And then we wait and see what happens.
That's it? That's your plan? We wait and see what happens?
Yes.
Oh, good.
All right, Devin, do you suggest this game? I think it's a pretty easy answer for you.
I wouldn't suggest this game, but film. I would definitely suggest the movie.
Sorry.
you are an idiot. No.
Fuck you.
You know what? We've already established that I'm the only person in this room that liked the movie.
No,
you said you didn't like the movie.
I would suggest it.
I
would suggest it, but as long as they don't watch it when I'm with me. You know?
I enjoy the film, and yes, I would suggest it. I wouldn't, I would suggest it because, A, it's a gorgeous film. It's absolutely stunning.
We all agree on that.
The way it looks, the way everything is. I would definitely suggest it.
Is it like it's just a rental, a buyer.
Well, I'm not going to tell somebody to buy a movie. Well, maybe if it's like Dark Knight or something, but
hold on. I tell them to buy that.
Definitely rent.
Just to see if you like it.
Because from what I understand, even like a lot of people, this isn't a movie that they would own, whether they liked it or not. You know,
just because of the graphics.
Yeah. So,
Gooch.
I'm pretty much the same way. I mean, it's not that I didn't know I didn't like it, but I always still suggest it. You know?
Trying to, God,
Lucho, you contradictory bastard.
But the problem is, I would suggest the film just because it's visually beautiful. You know, if you like to watch, beautiful things on your TV, I'd watch this film. Mind you, the story's kind of lackluster. You know, it kind of teeters off in the middle. But, I would suggest it. Definitely rental, though. I would buy it.
Well, you know what? The way I feel about it is, we all agree the graphics are spectacular. And I really feel that, if you have a Blu-ray player and you have a quality, high-definition television, you should find some way to get your hands on the Blu-ray and just watch it at least once. If you want to buy it, just for the sheer visual quality of it, you actually might want to do that if you can find it on sale or something like that.
It's a beautiful movie.
It really looks spectacular. And the Blu-ray has a lot of extra good features.
It does.
But as a film, if you're looking for a great... If you're a Final Fantasy lover, you need to stay away from this. If you don't know anything about Final Fantasy, then you might want to try watching
it. What were some of those features?
They had making of features. They had how they created the special effects. They even had the dream sequence. They had it uncut. So they put it all together as just one sequence, whatnot. There's various other interviews with the different people and stuff like that. So there's a lot. There's actually a lot of stuff.
There was a lot of stuff in there.
So if you're really into the movie, it actually is. It just has some value.
I must go back and watch this because that was obviously another movie.
When you went to sleep. So Devin, what's the life bar at?
So totaling all of our scores, this movie's life bar is at a 53%. It's not dead, it's still kicking. Middle of the road, it's not anything spectacular to write home to mama to, but...
Okay, so Devin, what are your health regens?
Obviously, visually, the movie's impeccable. I thought it was entertaining. I liked it. Basically, it's a visual powerhouse, let's put it that way. That's probably the strongest regen that we're all, going to have for it. I guess you can go and talk about the sound and stuff like that, but honestly, the biggest plus for this movie, the way it looks.
For me, I agree. My first health region is the graphics and the sound, mainly the graphics. I can't say it again. It's a beautiful looking movie. And the other health region I have is the acting. The acting is actually really good. Apart from the terrible script, but it's actually pretty good. The acting did the job.
Yeah, on this one, obviously I believe the graphics and sound are some things that are really actually, groundbreaking. But I also believe that, you see a lot of games right now that have obviously, computer graphic rendered, cutscenes and all stuff like that. But this really is a cut above any of that. And I really think that the mouth movement and stuff, it really actually lets you get into the movie. Instead of having to sit there and be like, crap, the guy animated that crap, terribly.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I really think that that's something that's really important. Yeah.
It adds to the immersion.
Exactly.
It doesn't take you out of the game.
So, Devin, Poisons.
Poisons, you know, love the film.
You don't have any? You might not have any.
I'm trying to think of some Poisons here. You know what? There wasn't anything about this movie that just made me completely hate it. So, no Poisons. Poisons.
Yeah. Gooch.
There's a
I don't even like Final Fantasy!
I just said the shit's full of androgyny. I hate chocobos because they're giant chickens.
It seems that Devin actually likes the movie more than he likes the Final Fantasy series.
Anyway,
one of the few out there.
God,
the biggest Poison for me on this one is it hasn't been like Final Fantasy at all. And that's it. That's it. I have nothing else to say.
You know, I really think that, you know, my poisons are is that, like Mitchell said, it does not have anything to do with Final Fantasy, but they could have made the same exact movie and still made it have more to do with Final Fantasy. Same story, same script. They could have just used a lot of Final Fantasy names for things and stuff like that. And just they could have made it a lot more immersive in Final Fantasy. Maybe I'm assuming that was their intention.
They could have been running from the Phantoms on Chocobos.
They could have, but they didn't, obviously. And also, I think the biggest poison for me is it's just not the entertainment of the story. It just doesn't really grip me that much.
And when people die, they
and
can
I tried
give
to like
downs.
It, man, but hey.
Throw a magic missile at him.
You don't sound like magic missiles.
That's all same nerd crap.
Hey, at least you're not standing there while floating swords are attacking.
Or pinning fools down with books.
We'll get to that in a little bit.
Jesus Christ.
So I guess that's it.
Yeah, so that is it. I am Devin DiNardo. This is Luis Alvarez with Clint Keaton. We just reviewed Final Fantasy The Spirits Within.
Watch out, my dude.